There are usually two points at which a user may notice a problem connecting to a camera. The first being when they attempt to add the camera to the system and see a status other than connected. The second, when a camera that was previously working is pulled up and no video is seen. This video aims to help provide several steps in attempting to diagnose common problems and how to fix them. When adding a new camera to a system, several troubleshooting messages are available in the ExactVision client based on the response or lack of response from the address entered. Connection error 504, for example, advises this address is on an unreachable network segment and you or the network administrator may need to configure additional routing rules. Request not found typically indicates the device didn't receive the correct message. You may be using the wrong device type to connect, so the camera or other IP device doesn't understand the connection attempt. It may help to check the IP camera database on the ExactVision website to determine if the device is supported, and if so, which device type to select. Refer to our video on using the IP camera database for more details. A camera stuck in a connecting status means the server may be continuing to attempt to talk to the device, but isn't receiving a response, such as if the device was offline or disconnected, or in some cases, the credentials were entered incorrectly. If a camera was previously connected but no longer connected, you may need to investigate possible network issues. Start by testing the ability to ping the camera. Using command on Windows systems or terminal on Linux Ubuntu systems, type the word ping followed by the IP address of the camera or device. This should indicate if the device can be reached or not. If the device is reachable, it indicates that a pathway at least exists to reach the camera. Note this ping test should be performed from the server, not a client workstation, as it is the server which must connect to it. Depending on your network environment, it could be possible for a client to successfully ping a camera, but the server cannot, and it is the server which really matters in this case. A ping is a low-level network test that is often the first step in many network troubleshooting cases to prove the device is not only online, but reachable. In the case of a successful ping test, you should then open a web browser and attempt to reach the camera's web interface, also from the server, not a client workstation. If the browser cannot load the camera's web interface, it may indicate the camera is having issues with its web server application and cannot send the necessary information. You could attempt to power cycle the device. If this still fails, contacting the camera manufacturer may be the next step. If the browser page does load, log into the camera interface. This will prove that the camera web service is working and that you have the correct credentials. If you cannot log in and the correct credentials cannot be found, you may need to factory default the device to configure it again as if it were just unboxed. Cameras are different, so if you do not know the steps to default the device, refer to the device's manual. Once logged into the camera, check to see that the camera provides a live image. If it does not, this could indicate a problem with the image sensor, and you should contact the camera manufacturer. If it does provide a live image, this is a good sign. However, the image you see in the web browser is an HTTP encoded stream. The ExactVision server records the camera's RTSP stream, which uses a different protocol and port number. You'll want to test the RTSP stream next. Refer to our video library for instructions on using the VLC media player to open an RTSP stream for testing. If the RTSP stream cannot be opened from the server, your network could be filtering or blocking traffic on port 554, which is used by RTSP. This is particularly common for those attempting to connect from an on-premises server to a camera across the internet at another site. Resolving this may require your network administrator configuring port forwarding rules on your router. If the RTSP stream can successfully be opened from the server, you should have no issues connecting to the RTSP stream to receive video within ExactVision. Therefore, there could be a potential issue in the API communication between the camera and the server. Again, check the IP camera database to ensure that you are using the tested combination of firmware and the ExactVision server. You may need to update one or the other to match the test records. Cameras may have multiple test records if tested with different server versions and camera firmware. If the camera is listed in the exact IP camera database and you are using the same firmware and server version as listed in the test records, you may contact Exact Support for further assistance. Lastly, we will touch on issues in which the camera connects and video is seen, but the video cuts in and out, displays pauses, or choppiness. Foremost is testing the video using the VLC media player as previously mentioned. If the same issue appears when viewing the stream in VLC, the issue lies with either the camera or the network. You can use VLC or the ExactVision client to help narrow this down further. Refer to the video on using VLC to find where this information can be seen there. In the ExactVision client, navigate to the Live Cameras page and open a single camera panel. Bring in the single camera experiencing an issue for viewing. In the bottom right corner of the desktop client is a live updating rate counter. By default, this display is kilobytes per second. Click this once to change the display to RFPS, short for received frames per second. Here we know this camera is set to display and record 10 frames per second. Now the counter will never be exactly 10 RFPS, but we should see it hover closely on either side, a little above or a little below. If the RFPS is very low, it means that not all the requested frames are arriving at the server. This indicates a network bandwidth problem, possibly some network congestion. If the RFPS drops too low, say somewhere around 1 or less, the stream may momentarily drop altogether, showing a gap in recording. Short gaps may display a frozen image. Longer gaps result in a video loss message in the client. Click the RFPS counter again and it changes to DFPS, decoded frames per second. If this number is very low, it indicates that the system's processor cannot handle the video frames quickly enough. You could have more cameras added to the system than it can handle at the image sizes and frame rates specified. You may attempt to resolve this by lowering frame rates or resolution across several cameras, or simply moving some cameras to a second server. Clicking the counter again changes the display to FPS. This indicates the frames being displayed in the client. A low number here indicates the system running the client, be it the server or a client workstation, has a display driver unable to keep up with the frames being requested to be shown. This problem is often encountered on lower-end workstations or when too many camera streams are being displayed at once. Try changing the live layout to display fewer camera streams at once to see if this helps, or you may consider a workstation with more powerful graphics ability.